Hello everyone, welcome to the session on visible surface detection methods, where we already discussed about some of the visible surface detection methods like binary space partitioning tree, which is discussed in my last video. And in the earlier videos we have discussed about the things, other visible surface detection methods like binary depth sorting, depth buffer, scan line method, and we also discussed about backface detection methods. So of all these methods, the backface detection method is acting as a preprocessor, where this method should be applied to all the methods so that we can identify the backfaces and that can be thrown out. Why we need to identify the backfaces? Because if we don't identify the backfaces, the methods what we have discussed till now and which we will be discussing in future, the method should be applied on those backfaces also, which is time consuming process. So to reduce the time, that means if you want to get the output very fast, then we need to apply the backface method, which identify the backfaces and we can throw out those backfaces so that the processing time will be reduced. Okay, so as part of visible surface detection method, which is broadly classified into by object space and image space, let us discuss one image space method. Our next method is of a type image space method, that is area subdivision method. So the next concept is area subdivision method, which is our sixth type, that is area subdivision method. Okay, if you remember, I told you like in all the methods we need to perform the depth sorting. As an example, we are considering the z-axis as your viewing direction. We need to perform the sorting of z-axis values, right? So that's why this all the methods are called as 3D view of your sorting algorithms. So and that the same thing where sorting, if you are concerned, that should also be applied here. And before applying this method, you need to apply the backface detection method to identify the backfaces, so that this method should not be applied, should not be run on your backfaces, which is a time consuming process. So let us see what is this area subdivision method. This comes under the category of image space method. What actually this method is? In this method, we as similar like binary space partitioning, the objects, the space which consists of the object should be considered as one space. And in this area subdivision method, the complete space should be divided into smaller and smaller areas until an area consists of a surface or no surface at all. Getting all of you, what we need to do? Consider the object's space, and that object space should be divided into smaller and smaller areas. Where each area, if you consider, that area should consist of at least one surface, or it consists of no surface at all. You need to perform the division like that. So if you go on dividing like that, you will be finally, or sometimes you need to leave that space if there is no surface. But if you have that surface, then you need to again divide that one, and finally you can end up with a space, or you can end up with a region where that there will be one pixel only. So you need to continue division from a big area to a pixel, single pixel area. So it is not the case like always we need to do division up to the single pixel area. You need to do the division according to your data present in that area. If no space is there, no need to divide that one. So general technique what we will be following in this area subdivision method is, I am telling that you need to divide, but how to divide is, the general approach they will be following is, we can divide this area into four areas, and individual area can be divided again into four areas, and individual area can be again divided into four areas. We need to continue like that until an area, a single pixel can be considered into one area. So the approach will be like this. Suppose this is your complete area. Okay, so we need to divide into four areas first, and we need to observe all the areas. Okay, and if there are any surfaces, we need to again divide that one. Let us consider this area is consisting of surface. We need to divide this one again. But if there is no surface in this area, there is that no requirement of dividing that area further. We can stop there, because there, as there is no surface, the requirement of dividing is not required. Okay, again this area, if you consider this is divided into 4, again this should be divided into 4 if there is any surface. You need to divide this one into 4, you need to divide this one, provided there is a surface. Now that division process will be continued until, let us consider this area is of 1 pixel. If you have reached a situation where that area represents only 1 pixel, again don't divide that one into 4 areas, because a pixel should not be divided into 4 areas. So this is how general scenario will be followed in our area subdivision method. Right? Now in this, what happens is, in area subdivision method, whenever you want to find out like the area, let us consider one area you have observed, that area is surrounded by any surface or not. To check that one, the surface boundary, whatever surface boundary you have, that surface boundary should be compared with your area boundary. So to do that, we have 4 options for that one. Now first, let us list out those surface boundaries and let us do what we have to do. Okay, so the first type of surface is surrounding surface. Second type of surface is overlapping surface. And third type of surface is inside surface. And the last type of surface is outside surface. So what is the use of these surfaces is, if you want to identify for a particular area if it is overlapped by any surface or not, if you want to check that one, you need to check with that surfaces. What is that one is, first we will see what is surrounding surface. Surrounding surface is nothing but, let us consider this is your area of division. In this surrounding surface, this area of division will be surrounded by a polygon. This is your polygon, let us consider. So if you consider this one as your area, this complete area is surrounded by your polygon. That is one case. The second case is overlapping surface. Overlapping surface is nothing but, for an area, if you consider this is your area, this area consists of a part of your surface that may some, that if you consider one surface, half of the part, some part will be inside the area and some part will be the outside of your area. That means the object may be like looking like this. So this is your area, where the area, within the area, the surface of that object may not be inside or may not be outside. It is like partially inside of your area. So the third one is inside surface. In the inside surface, what happens is, if you consider any area, let us consider this is the area. Within this area, the object will be completely available in your area. So that is also what it is. So where within this area, after dividing, in this area, the surface will be completely available. The fourth type is outside surface, where if this is the area after dividing, the surface, whatever you are considering, that may be completely outside of your surface. So these are the 4 cases. So of the four cases, if you consider this one, you should not bother about this one, because that is completely away of your area. No need to further divide this one. If you consider this one here, as it is completely inside of this one, you need to scan and convert this one. If you consider this one, for this one and this case, you need to observe like, if any other surface are overlapping this one or not. So, okay. So, in that case, what you need to do is, we need to check for overlaps. So, if you have 2 surfaces, as we are doing, you will be having 2 surfaces. Only one surface, but behind that surface, is there any overlaps or not? So such case should be identical. If such overlaps are there, we need to follow the same trick what we have followed in the earlier methods. What is that method is? We need to find out the depths, and those depths should be sorted, and according to the sorting of those, the largest depth value surface should be scanned and converted first, and the nearer one, and then the nearer one, and the procedure should be continued. That is how, in case of depth overlaps or in case of surface overlaps, we need to find. But the general scenario in the area subdivision method is, you need to find out the surrounding surfaces and the boundary of your area rectangle. Depending upon that, you need to whether divide the surface or not, you need to finalize that one. After your division process is done, then you need to check for your surface overlaps, and surface overlaps are there, then you need to find out the depth, and depending upon the depth, the surface should be scan covered. This is how area subdivision method will be working. Thank you.